Alright, hey guys, California Mackie here, doing well, and welcome to Gilded Hearts. You see, I got to this really late, so I'm here to make up for it. And they have a Kickstarter ending in a few days. Actually, it might be just a day and a half once I get this done and edited. So I hope you guys get the chance to donate. I'll put the link in the description and a pinned comment. Anyway, let's make our character. This is one of the few games that actually lets me make a character like this. Let's go. I got that skin. Actually, let's go with the Final Fantasy kind of colored hair. My green eyes. And green shirt. I am Kelly. And the screen name is... You guessed it. Nice job tonight, everyone. Yeah, that was sick. Congrats on the new staff, Enos. Thanks. The Calamic dude, your damage, what the fuck? I know, as a white mage. Yeah, I was trying out something Vern had suggested. Credit goes to him, really. Not at all, you were great. I'm heading off, I'll upload the logs later. Great work, team. I've never been into the MMO scene until recently, with Final Fantasy XIV, and even then, I'm still a sprout and haven't really put much effort into it. I don't have a group yet, and I'm still at a Realm Reborn. Look, I haven't paid for FF14 yet, it's still at the trial base phase, and I'm a level 35 white mage. I only throw rocks. See ya! I lean back in my chair and rub my eyes tiredly. It's only 10 p.m, but I've got an early class tomorrow. Fuck, I just realized. I have work tomorrow. Oh no. What do I do? Just as I think about logging off though, I hear a ping from my computer. It's my close friend and longtime officer in our Lost Heroes Guild, Verdon. I'm recording late at night, so I'm a little worried actually. So I'm keeping an eye out everywhere and also watching the clock. How did you find that? As much as I really should go to sleep, I can't resist replying. Pretty good, to be honest. To start with, I was worried we wouldn't get it down, but we made quick progress. Thanks again for recommending that build. It was fire! No worries. I just saw it featured on this content creator I follow, so I thought I'd pass it along. I'm gonna tweak it a little, I think, but definitely using it as a base from now on. Cool. You up to anything before the rest of the night? I should really get to bed. Real life me should too, but then I'm working. Gotta head to bed soon, I've got class in the AM, I don't wanna be sleepy. Oh yeah, you changed your major, right? Yep, I'm in coding 101. But I'm starting later than everyone else, I'm way behind. Then you best get some sleep. We'll chat tomorrow? Sure! You still have to clear out that polar bear cave for your gem quest, right? You know, this really reminds me of FF14. I've only interacted with Hoodie and his friends at FF14. A friend of mine, a VTuber guy, Hoodie. He's really big. So big. I barely fits. Yeah. He also introduced me to mods. All the sassy mods! I think my brother's coming home tomorrow anyways. So I might have to help him out around the house. He's been away again? Yeah, just for the weekend. Where was he this time? I don't know, out of the country. He doesn't really tell me. Anyway, you've gotta really get some sleep. Yeah, you're right. Night, speak tomorrow. Good night! I shut down the PC and head out my room, grabbing the empty glass from my desk. I wash up and then get ready for bed. Just as I'm approaching the kitchen A in my shared accommodation, though, I hear the front door open. It's my roommate, Casper, back from his audition. He's a theater major. It's his final year. It's just the two of us here in this little off-campus place. I got moved here a few weeks ago when I switched majors and Casper came the week after me. We haven't spoken much since we moved in. I'm still not sure why he got put with a freshman. If you're living with somebody, you might as well try to be amicable. But if that doesn't work out, don't force it. He seems to be really friendly. So I'm hoping we get to speak more. Doesn't hurt that he's easy on the eyes either. Oh. Cheeky. Tonight he's looking pretty dejected. Aww. I wonder if something bad happened. Hey, Callie. Hi. How are ya? Oh, there's my own model. Well, honestly, not great. I just completely threw that audition. Oh man, what happened? Hold on, I'm gonna hide my avatar just so that you guys can see. Oh! Oh yeah, he definitely deserves some attention here. Mm-mm. He walks further into the room, pulling his shoes off, shoes off and flops onto the couch. I just got up all in my head about it. This is the dream, you know? I'm so close, and then I think about how this one could be the one, and it just gets me all jittery. I'm just not in the right headspace. That sounds rough. He nods. I feel sorry for him. I haven't seen him look this down before. It must have been a really important audition. You know what? I'm gonna be a kind of friend who's gonna pry gently. Gently. You wanna talk about it? Honestly, not really. I just wanna forget it ever happened. I glance at the clock and apologize in advance to my future self. You want some ice cream? You look like you could use some. Any flavor you like. My treat. I suppose I've not had my ice cream since breaking up with Danny. Yeah, go on then. Neapolitan if they have it. Strawberry will do if they don't. Nothing's wrong with Neapolitan. I actually enjoy it. It's the best, isn't it? Maybe I'll let you share if you're lucky. I laugh and elbow him. Thanks, Callie. My pleasure. I grab my coat off the hook up by the door and slip my feet into my comfy shoes. See you in 5. Heading out the door and across the road, I make my way to the convenience store. It's nice living in the city. Everything is so close by. Lil Buzza greets me as I head inside. Well, hello. Archie is behind the counter as usual, on his laptop. I often come in here late after finishing a raid, and he's always in the night shift. You know, we should at least see the laptop. I just realized. Otherwise, not an issue. We never exchange words beyond the basic pleasantries, but I think it's really hot. I locate the ice cream quickly. Luckily, they have Neapolitan, and grab myself an energy drink and a bag of chips. I'm going to need the boost in the morning. On my way to the counter, I notice a guy standing really close to the alcohol and looking around. It looks a little shifter, so I keep my eye on it. Archie looks up as I approach and stands, ready to scan my items. Hey. Will this be all? Yeah, thanks. I'm still watching the shady person out the corner of my eye. He moves too suddenly to be natural, keeps looking behind him nervously. You got a shoplifter. I can't just sit by and let someone steal. Something about the man who stands by and sees evil being done is as bad as the evildoer himself. You know? I speak to Archie with a low voice. Excuse me. I think that guy over there might be lifting your beer. His eyes widen and shift past me to the perpetrator. You're right, he is. Hey, you! Falls over the counter and runs towards the figure. We need a cutscene of that. The shoplifter panics and makes a break for the door, even if it's just a small cut in. Before I can even think about it, my feet move instinctively and I bar his way. He skids to a stop soaring, but before I can turn around, Archie is on him. He tackles him to the floor and pulls 4 cans of beer out of his pockets. Get on me, I was going to pay for those. Sure you were, buddy. Get out and be grateful I'm not calling the cops. Fuck you, dickhead. The would-be thief stands up, spits at Archie's feet, and runs off. Thanks for your help there. What's your name? I've seen you in here before, I think. It's Callie. I live around the corner from here, so I come in now and again. Nice to meet you, Archie. Likewise. You saved my ass back there. Anything that gets stolen in my ship comes out of my paycheck, so that would have been a real pain. Thanks.
No problem.
Why are you blushing? What the hell? Why are you blushing, mate? I'm so taken aback by his gorgeous strawberry blonde hair and warm arms that I'm struck to get the words out. This is bad. He grins at me and I feel like I might faint. I owe you one. Let me know if I can ever pay the favor, okay? Sure, I'll see you around. I pay for my items, and with a final wink, Archie waves goodbye. How do people as cute as him even exist? And inside the convenience store. I can't wait to cash in that favor. Oh my god! What happens next? Before long, I'm back home. Casper is still on the couch, idly watching television. I grab 2 spoons, kick my shoes off, and slump on the couch beside him. Oh, You'll never guess what happened to me. Attacked by a bear. Almost. Caught a shoplifter. Whoa, really? Up in the tub and offer him a spoon. He takes it and weaves again. Yeah, I'm surprised I kept my cool. Especially with the guy behind the counter being, well, to be honest, super hot. Aww. Is this really the time? Gaspar raises an eyebrow at this. Corner shop guy? I suppose I can see it if you're into blondes. Didn't know you like guys though. Yeah, I've been out since I was about 15. Cool, same here. I came out pretty early, though I suppose it was fairly easy for me with a background in theater. People are more surprised when you're straight. I'm lucky. No traumatic family reaction, no lost friends. My whole life just kind of carried on. You're right that we're the lucky ones. My life was pretty perfect, to be honest, at least until I met Danny and everything went tits up. Aw, his smile dimmed. But that's a story for another time. I've had enough of being maudlin tonight. Tell me about that online game you play. I hear you're talking to your friends all the time. I'm surprised to hear that Casper's interested. He doesn't seem like the gaming type, but I decide to humor his change of subject. It's called Lost Heroes. You heard of it? There was a club for it in my high school. Beyond that, no. It's an MMORPG. Basically, you play online with a bunch of other people. You've got all your standard fantastical archetypes, wizards, warriors, thieves, you name it. You create your own character and do quests to level up, earn cool armor, gain reputation with the city folk, and kill the final boss. That's what we call raids. Because I need help. Help! Help! For that, you need a raid group of 25 people, and we have to talk on comms, so that's probably what you're hearing. Sounds pretty epic, to be honest. I was always into those kinds of stories as a kid. I guess I just never found my way into playing video games. Do you think maybe you could teach me to play? Sounds like fun. I mean, sure. Pretty flabbergasted, but take this as a good opportunity to get to know my roommate better, and the guild could always use more members. For sure, I'll send you the link to download it. Do I have your number? I don't think so. Here, give me your phone. He adds this number to my phone and hands it back with a grin. Cool, I'm looking forward to this, Callie. It's been a while since I picked up anything new. I should head to bed now, though. It's been a long day. I deliberately avoid glancing at the clock. I don't even want to know how tired I'm going to be tomorrow. Putting the remaining ice cream in the freezer, I turn the television off, leave the spoons in the sink, and bid Casper goodnight as we enter our respective rooms. It'll definitely be fun teaching him to play. Perhaps I'll get Vernet in on it, too. He's always online and has been playing for years, so he knows the game better than anyone. It might be nice for him to meet Casper too. Other than me, he doesn't really have any friends. Ah. How long have you known each other? I settle into bed, energy drink, and university laptop by my bedside ready for the morning. If someone's suspiciously absent in your friend group, that means that's them. Never. A buzzing alarm wakes me up and I scramble to turn it off. It's far too early. With a groan, I pull myself out of bed, traipse into the bathroom to make myself presentable. Professor insists on us being on camera when we talk. I finish up shaving and brushing my hair, then find some relatively clean clothes. I'm at my laptop with the virtual classroom loaded up with just seconds to spare. Good morning, class. I hope you are all excited because today you're going to be starting your first project. Something that I noticed, when I click outside of this text box, nothing happens during these kinds of seats. It really encourages you to click on the chat box, message box. So I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. It's just a nice little thing that I noticed. Please go into your separate chat rooms and greet each other. Following the professor's instructions, I enter chat room B. I haven't been in the class long and only know a bunch of other course mates, so I'm hoping that I've been put with someone I speak to. Soon enough, three others join the chat. Warren, a quiet guy who doesn't really interact. Lucy, an outgoing girl I've spoken to once or twice with half blue and half pink hair who loves wearing Harley Quinn tops. And... oh no. Anyone but this guy. Who is it? Guillermo? Wow, really? Professor Hodge put me with you? Obviously, he thinks you're failing and needs me to pull your grades up. There's no way he'd stick me here otherwise. Guillermo. He's a bellend. Surely he can't be all bad. He's been a pompous prick since day one and nobody can stand the guy. I think he thinks he's better than everyone else here and won't work with anyone. The kind of guy you step out of the way to avoid in public. Internally groaning, I try to concentrate on the assignment. Each one of us has to create code for a different part of a functioning website. Oh fuck, that's good. That sounds horrible. Especially if you split the delegate parts and you hope to God that it all fits. I focus diligently on my section, ignoring the pings from the chat for a while. When I look back at it, it's almost all Guillermo messaging. Aren't you finished yet? You're all so slow, this is unreal. Yeah. I can't with him, I'm sorry. He's literally the worst. Yeah, I know what you mean. Really hope we aren't stuck with him all semester. Main chat pings again. He's joined our meeting. Hope you're all getting on well. Your group is responsible for the creation of a website, but you'll be working in pairs on each section. By the end of the project, expect a fully functioning site built from the ground up. It's up to you how do you delegate the responsibilities, but each pair must put in 50% of the work. I'll be assigning pairs who complement each other's styles. Oh fuck, of course they're gonna pair us with the asshole. So based on your personal preferences when it comes to coding functions, and your level of ability, of course, I'll be pairing Warren, Lucy, and Callie with Guillermo. I'm not surprised. Please ensure you work well with your partner. After all, teamwork is the key to any successful venture. If you have any questions, you may contact me via email. Could I just speak with you quickly? For fuck's sake. Callie, I hope you know I'm not happy about this. Yeah, I got that loud and clear, Guillermo. No worries, I'm not exactly thrilled to be working with you either. Sorry, but Warren and I are going to start our own chat just for now. We'll catch up with you two when we have the first part done. Sorry, buddy, it's him, not you. Yeah, I know, no hard feelings. Wish me luck, lol. You're gonna need it. He really looks like a pompous asshole. I wonder if we can break the ice, so to speak. Why am I in a scratch? Let's not think about that. He's annoyingly handsome, although his gorgeous brown features are curled into a sneer. I know you don't like me, but you've got work with me, so let's just get this done. Don't speak too soon, I'm emailing the professor right now. He's not going to change to your partner. I doubt he'll even read your email. Well, I'm not working with you all year. My grades will never recover. You're so full of yourself, Jesus. Look, I'm gonna focus on the project, okay? Let me know when you're ready to stop being a child and get this done. That's one way to end it. More elegant than what I thought. He doesn't message me again for the rest of the day, thank God. How can someone who looks that good be that unbearable? You'd be surprised. I message her then. Don't tell me. Don't tell me. If Guillermo is verdant, I'm gonna fucking kick my nuts. It only takes him a minute to reply. Hey, what's up? God, I need to take a break and murder some corrupted bears. You up for doing your quest? Sorry, I can't write number. Brother just got home. You need you for something? It's complicated. Sorry. I can still chat for a bit, though. I just can't get involved in any big quests. Alright, logging in then. Load up the game and log in, finding myself in the Wits End Tavern, where it's... I'm at my Wits End. After the raid. Verdant's character is here too, sitting at table with a mug. I join him and grin. His character is a burly paladin with our strongest healer. I play as sorcerer, so I'm always grateful to have him along with me on quest to keep me alive. For all the time I've known him, almost 2 years now, I still don't know what he looks like or even his real name. He's quite a private person. If he's Guillermo, I'm gonna fucking punt something. All I know is that he lives alone with his older brother and his son Lost Heroes basically 24/7. Hey. Hey! Rough morning class then? You have no idea. The prof paired me with this complete jackass, and I have to work with him all year. Oh man. I'm honestly not sure at this situation. Oh wait, the gear icon changed too! That's a neat detail. Here's something though, I don't know if I you know what, let's keep venting. I know, I was actually looking forward to this project too, geez. What a bitch of a thing to happen in my first semester. I don't know what to say. Oh, good news though. You know Casper, right? My roommate? You've told me about him. The actor musician guy? Yeah, him. He's going to come play with us soon. Really? Yeah, we chatted about the game last night and he seems super into it. I think he's downloading it later today. You wanna get in on teaching him? Could be fun. Definitely. It's always... You know, it's still early. I can imagine this guy smiling.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. It's always fun welcoming the new guildies. Good. I'll find out later when he's around and introduce you to. Sounds good. Oh, sorry. I've gotta go AFK for a bit. My brother's calling me. Back in a bit. Feels like me. I'm kind of concerned by that. I hope it's nothing too serious. See you later. Oh, this is rendered. Spend the day helping a farmer clear his farm of a kobold infestation. By the time I'm done, it's well into the afternoon. Sit up and stretch languidly, wondering what to do next. Oh!
There's a... Can you really find true love? In an MMO?
You'd be surprised how much. I played on VRChat. Yay!
Guild Hearts!
Don't forget, I still owe you that favor.
Oh, fuck!
Who
they have voices.
You can't be a musician, an actor, and a gamer.
What do you mean, what's up? You're late to our first study session.
You'll get there. We were all new once.
Customize your character. Oh, yeah. And help him find love.
Help him find love. Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Oh. Gilded Hearts.
Now available on Kickstarter. Please support us on Kickstarter, please. I owe it to them. There's going to be a lot of exclusive stuff. I'm really hoping. Check out our Kickstarter campaign. Every pledge gets us closer to making our dream for Gilded Hearts into a reality. Continue. So, that's it for Gilded Hearts for now. I want to thank those who reached out to me from Argent Games and Gallium Games. Thank you guys so much. Actually, I'm not sure how different the entities are, but they're definitely working together since it's at the entrance intro card. So yeah, that's Gilded Hearts. I hope you guys can support the game. I'm gonna donate a few bits that I can manage for the game as well. And there's still a few hours left. So please, get on there and enjoy the game. You can try out this demo for yourselves. Take a different route from what I took. But this is a really, really, really quick coverage of what's in store. I hope this piqued your interest because I'm definitely interested, especially as a lead gamer nerd who's dipping his toes into MMOs because back then he couldn't afford it because they were really expensive and Garena is a piece of shit, let me tell you that. Anyways, that's all for now. California Mackie signing out, and remember, Kickstarter support! We're doing this! I hope we reached the goal. I'm really late to it, I really apologize. Anyway, signing out. Bye for now.